in the possible couple possibly out of a honeymoon. Luckily, Franklin police believe they have their man. Fox 59's Mike Sullivan explains what happened when this thief struck at their wedding and at their home.
After a wedding, you're generally for richer than for poorer.
It's like Christmas with my own stuff.
In just a matter of hours, Mitch Lawson saw those wedding vows take an unexpected turn.
Day after my wedding, woke up hungover to this.
Their honeymoon fund was in a box at the venue. His friends and family partied the night away in Nashville, Indiana. A thief tapped it dry.
That money is still MIA.
That alone would be enough to ruin a wedding. Except when Mitch got home, he checked his garage.
I moved the tarp, realized all of my tools had been gone.
An estimated $4,500 worth. Lawson owns a construction business. No tools, no work.
And now I have to go to all the investors I work with and tell them their projects are on hold that they have deadlines for.
Meanwhile, his brother-in-law was just getting the news.
When he found out, he tripped out a little bit. I don't think it really hit him, though, that, like, you don't have a job either at the moment.
Little did his brother-in-law know, he was best friends with the suspected thief, had even invited him to the wedding.
Oh, dude, some stuff we didn't even know he took, like that. It's not even mine.
Franklin police arrested 23-year-old Christian Alstott.
Unfortunately, he wrote his name on a lot of my stuff.
Police reports say he attempted to sell the tools, even asked people to help in the robbery, but they refused.
You have no idea. I about hit the floor and crying when I saw all my tools sitting there in the bullpen of the Franklin police station.
Not quite the tears of joy he was expecting on his wedding night.
So this is pretty much all of it.
But surely he will take it. In Franklin, I'm Mike Sullivan, Fox 59 News.
Lawson believes Alstott is also responsible for the missing honeymoon cash, but that's not a part of the Franklin investigation. He's now facing stolen property charges. We're following some breaking news tonight on the city's east side. We've learned